Today we look at two really awesome aircraft and get an understanding of the differences between them, partially due to the fact that there has been much controversy over whether one aircraft should be replaced by the other, at least within the United States. Today we look at the differences between the historical F-16 and the battle-proven F-35. How's it going, everybody? Welcome to FTD Facts. My name is Dave Wobble, and today, yeah, we're going to look at the F-16 and the F-35. Me, I'm a big fan of the F-16. I think it's one of my favorite fighters in the modern world. But the F-35, you know, there's a lot of people that say it's just a really good aircraft, but like I said, controversy, is it worth the price? Well, let's just find out some of the differences. Now, before I get in this video, if you guys like military content and all that stuff and you want more, hit that like button. Also hit that subscribe button if you're new here. And be sure to keep an eye out on our unique playlists that I've kind of tailored to people who like military content. It'll be in the description box below or in the boxes throughout this video. Before we get in this video, guys, I want to do a quick little mention of this amazing game that I've been playing for the last couple of weeks. Now, this is Viking War of Clans. Now, the reason I tell you guys about this is because I know you guys are here because you're interested in military topics, and I know that you're most likely interested in war kind of games, and thus, this is Viking War of Clans. Now, I bring this to you guys because it is an amazing browser game that is free to play. One of the best things is if you join for free by using my link in the description box below, you get 200 gold coins to just start up the game. What's great about it is it's got good social features. You can play with other people from around the world. You can use your browser. And one of the best things that I like about using a browser over using my phone is that you just, you know, can use a mouse, and of course, you can just get better graphics. So check out this really addictive game. I really think you guys will like it, but let's get started on the video. The F-16 is sleek, it's slender, and it's just one awesome aircraft. It has been around since the 1970s, designed originally by General Dynamics, now basically manufactured by Lockheed Martin. It started its service in 1978 after its first flight commenced in 1974. Now, one of the many reasons for the creation of the single-seat fighter and bomber multi-role aircraft was because of the lessons learned from the F-4 Phantom experiences in Vietnam. Basically, the F-4 Phantom was a very good fighter. The only downside is it did get shot down quite a bit in Vietnam. And therefore, the United States of America wanted to minimize that. As well, there was the F-15, which was a somewhat good aircraft, which came before. And of course, research and development from the F-15 went into the F-16. The F-15, although being a very good fighter, did have its problems. One of the big problems was that not only was it expensive, but it was a rather large aircraft to be doing dogfighting with. Now, the F-35, it's very interesting how this fighter came to be. Very similar to how the F-16 began to be a more cheap and effective improvement off of the F-15, the F-35 is sometimes considered a cheaper, more effective improvement off of the F-22 Raptor. The F-22 Raptor was a major improvement on technology, but the downside was it was not only costly, but there wasn't a lot of customization options for foreign buyers. As well, with the introduction of the F-35, the Navy Marines got an opportunity to request that this fighter have a different engine built within it, made for vertical takeoff, to replace the Harriers that the Navy currently was downsizing. And this just wasn't a feature that the F-22 had when it was in development. Eventually, this all led to the cancellation of the F-22, and in 2005, the F-35 had its first flight. Ironically, though, for the F-35, the B versions, which are the ones that have the VTOL ability, was introduced first into the military before the more conventional takeoff versions were available. So for combat history, let's just take a look at the obvious. Of course, there are way more F-16s than there are F-35s. That's because it's been around for a long time. In today's world, there are currently at least 4,604 of these F-16 fighters being made as of 2018, making it the world's most numerous fixed-wing aircraft. The F-35, however, has at least 380 of these aircrafts made as of 2019. Now, looking at the F-16, it has had an operational history in the United States, Israel, Pakistan, Turkey, Egypt, the UAE, Jordan. As well, within Europe, there has been the Netherlands, Belgium, Denmark, Norway, in which all of these countries listed have either flown currently or in the past. On top of that, there's also Venezuela, Morocco, Bahrain, and countries like Croatia and Slovakia have interest in these fighters and purchased them in 2018. Italy actually did fly F-16s at one point, but the lease was up some time ago. And with that, so far they say that there is at least 25 air forces from around the world that operate the F-16. For the F-35, the United States is pretty much the main operator. However, Lockheed Martin stated that there are other countries that are in the process of getting full squadrons or are in development of these deals. These are the countries like the United Kingdom, Australia, the Netherlands, Italy, Denmark, Norway, Japan, Belgium. Canada, however, has been back and forth of whether or not they should invest, as well as the country of Norway. Turkey at one point did have an interest in this aircraft, however, unfortunately, there was a transfer ban between them. This is because Turkey was interested in Russia's S-400 air defense system, which is one of the best air force defense systems in the world. This is simply because the F-35 is made to beat the S-400 series, so it's kind of like, you know, you don't want to give away too many of your secrets. Besides that, there is also a large amount of countries that do have interest in the F-35, but nothing's really moved forward. For variants, though, let's take a look. Now, yes, the F-16 has a lot of them, but like I said, it's been around for a long time. Originally starting off with the A and B versions, B being the two-seater, this was eventually upgraded to the C and D, which is now pretty much the E and F version. Of the C and D version, there is also the F-16N, which has some minor changes specific to the Navy. Keep in mind, within these different versions, there's also what you call block changes. There's also a lot of other versions that have specific changes for certain types of jobs. On top of that, there is country versions and a couple of offshoot fighters that come from the F-16, such as the South Korean KAI T-50 Golden Eagle and Japan's Mitsubishi F-2. The F-35, however, has three main versions. You've got A, B, and C. A is your traditional takeoff, and you've got B, which classifies as a VTOL aircraft. C, however, is a little bit larger in its wings. As a matter of fact, its wings actually fold up. This helps the C version handle better at lower speeds, and it's good for aircraft takeoff and storage. The F-35I is one that is being developed for Israel, and it features Israeli countermeasures and electronics, which the United States eventually had to agree to. As for other upgrades, there's the F-35D, but that's kind of in talks and thought of development. However, they have no plans to do a major upgrade until about 2035. Performance aspect, let's take a look. One major difference is that the F-35 is classified as a stealth fighter. The F-16 obviously is not. Both are single-engine fighters and do classify both as multi-role aircraft. But with that, let's take a look at how they perform and their engines. For speed, the F-16 is a lot faster, coming in at Mach 2, whereas the F-35 comes in at Mach 1.6. As for their ceiling ability, both of them are effective up to 50,000 feet. It has been said that the F-16 is capable of going higher. The thrust on these aircrafts for the F-35 has 43,000 pounds over the F-16's 29,000 pounds. For range, the F-16 combat radius is approximately 550 kilometers. However, its ferry range is 2,620 kilometers. The F-35, however, is said to go up to 28,000 kilometers. Keep in mind that is really hard to say because there is so many different versions that have different engines. And even though the F-16 generally has the same engine in all of its versions, there are a few that make this exception. For example, F-16s use generally the Pratt Whitney engines. However, countries like the UAE use a General Electric engine. The opposite, however, goes to the F-35 because the A, B, and C version, because there's different types of aircraft, they got different engines. For the F-35, the A and C version use a Pratt Whitney engine, whereas the B uses a Rolls-Royce engine for its VTOL. On top of that, there is a major fuel capacity change on different versions, so that's something to be taken into effect. So when it comes to these ranges of these aircraft and the engine abilities, it's not across the board. However, one of the biggest differences between these two aircrafts is dogfighting. While yes, it's true the F-16 wins in a dogfight, the F-35, keep in mind, wasn't really designed for that. It was made for a much longer range, being able to use its stealth abilities, fire, and get out of dodge, almost preventing the dogfight from happening in the first place. Some people have also criticized how the F-35 is capable of having a really effective tracking system. For example, it can track up to 20 targets at a time. And some say that the F-16 is incapable of doing that. Well, that's not necessarily true, because the new F-16V variant has the same electronics, being able to do the same thing electronically in terms of tracking. For weapons, the F-16 has so many years of weapon integration that the F-35 won't be able to compete with it currently. Also, because of its stealth abilities, the USA isn't big on giving the F-35 aircraft to just any country. For example, we learned about Turkey and its ban. The F-16, however, is more of a foreign-friendly aircraft. And just to touch on the F-35's stealth abilities, although not much is known about it because it is very hush-hush top secret, there is some controversy of over how long it will be effective for, as Israeli Air Force officials even debate how long its stealth will be good for. They estimate anywhere between 5 to 10 years until countermeasures come into effect. As for price, this is generally where you get into the big controversy of which one is better and better for countries. Because the F-16 has been around for a lot longer, it is much more cheaper than an F-35, coming in at 21 to 28 million, whereas one F-35 starts at 89.2 million for its lowest version. Either way, guys, that is me looking at the differences between these two aircrafts. Yes, there are a lot of other things that we could talk about, but this is getting to be a long video enough as it is. Who knows, maybe I'll do a part two. So if there are some things that I missed, be sure to leave it down there in the comment section below. Other than that, be sure to check out our other playlists. If you guys like this stuff and you want to recommend another video for us, you can do it down there as well. But my name is Dave Wapple. Thanks for tuning in, and you guys just have yourself a fantastic day. Okay, cool. All right. Okay, guys, well, if you like this video, you should check out our other cool playlists. We got some great military stuff, especially if you like fighters. This is just our cool videos on fighters. We've done so many of them, so feel free to check those out, but we'll see you guys later. Okay, bye.